Oh, we live.
I sound super fast on this. I don't know if we're live yet. Welcome to the replay of a live stream. If you're watching this 2 days after, we are live. Oh, you know what? I forgot to set up my keyboard, man. So we're live. I got a brand new plugin from Jacob called Deluxe. It's Minecraft music for you. All right, let's make sure we're live before I just start rambling. So anyway, Jacob came out with this octave plugin, and he just made the deluxe version, which has a crazy amount of sounds. So shout out to Jacob. His producer name is my best friend, Jacob. And I just added a ton of sounds to this. Look at this list. It's an insane amount of sounds. So he's one person that I've respected sound selection 100% because I saw his process. We were up in Canada making sounds for 2 days straight, just working 2 days straight. And I got to see how thorough he is with his thought process. So he's one person I can definitely respect the process. And he's just like, yo, man, we got a bunch of new sounds. Let me just send you this new copy of it. So I don't know if it's out yet. So I can't give you all details on where to go. He probably has to text me if there's a website. But can you hear me? Is the mic good? One Indeed, what's up? D-Cuz, what's up? I'm doing all right. I'm not at the studio right now because I just don't feel like driving. I didn't realize 1 hour of driving one way and then back eats up so much gas. Not that I care about the gas, but just running up miles on my car. My car is in these streets for real. Susan Shiniyama, what's up? King Sue is here. I am King Sue. And then we'll do the feedback at 9 p.m. Eastern time. John Spark says, you're back in the basement. Yeah, it's funny because I'm in the complete opposite of the basement. I'm in the top floor. But yes, back in the Osama Caverns. The Eddos, what's up? Momo, what's up? Hip Hop Group 2. Speaking of Osama, those squiggly letters, what's up? Produced by 8-Bit. What's going on? So let me begin because people who watch the replay, they tend to have a different experience since they're not live with us. And so they, you know, they don't want to hear all this jibber jabber. So let me begin. All right. What up? Young Chef Legend, Young Chef West. Okay. So Jacob's sound design is crazy for one. Like, I don't even need to do anything and it's already a vibe. So I know his process and he's very thorough with it. Let me see, what kind of beat can we make? I'm just gonna make a bunch of beats. I like this sound. My ear gravitates towards that note E. So I don't have my MIDI keyboard on me, and it's a long story, but I don't have it. Do I have one? I might have one in the closet. Even if I did have one, there's nowhere to plug it up because I don't have a little port thing for it. You said, yo, what up? If submit now, can I still be considered? We're doing that at 9 p.m. Eastern time. So you have up until 9 p.m. to get your song ready. That's not... Yeah, submissions, you can submit once we go live at 9. All right, so this already has like a Travis Scott-esque vibe to it. We don't even need to do anything. We don't need to add any effects. Somebody disliked the live stream. Good for them. You know, they went with their emotions. For once, I'm going to do a live stream where I just address haters on Zoom. I'm just going to let the haters call me up and tell me why they think I suck. I just want to know. I'm curious. Yeah, no Subway for me. I'm trying to change up the diet anyway. Make it more protein and then vegetable based instead of so many carbs. Yeah, I'm promoting. I like to advertise in a different way. If everybody's doing one thing, I'm going to do something completely different. And I advertised my live stream where I went over my new plugin. Because it feels like a normal video. The whole trick to advertising is to figure out how to blend into the culture of wherever you're trying to advertise. So people are used to live streams anyway. Because when they... Here's a little trick I'll just share with you since you're inquisitive, hood known. When I run that ad, people don't even know it's an ad. They just think that, you know how on YouTube, if you're done a video, it goes to the next video automatically. they just think that it automatically went to some other video. So they don't get mad about it because they just assume that that's what's happening. And that's how I get away with that ad. And it's doing pretty good. So let's do long notes. So we did short, fast notes. It's a little ad secret for y'all, for those who know. But yeah, I want to have a live stream with just haters calling me up on Zoom so you can see what they look like and then hear what they have to say. Because a lot of people are misled. You know, they don't even like, they don't have any facts about Busy Works Beats. They just say stuff because they heard it from somewhere else and it's just not true. So I'm going to allow them to talk and then we're going to feed them the truth. And I'm not going to be emotional about it. So it's going to be objective facts. Too many notes. I think us producers also, here's a little side note. We tend to overly like fill our melody because we're that's just how our brain is. You gotta learn how to cut back so many things in your melody. Like some of you more people are more musical and you think you have to do like a 1-4-5-1 chord progression in the melody. Sometimes in trap music that makes it too musical and then it takes it out of the genre. So you gotta be really careful when you get too musical with trap. I'm missing a lot of stuff. Yo, what's up? That's old. Today, I'm just going to be messing with this octave plugin from Jacob. He sent me over this Octave Deluxe, which is crazy. He added new skins to this. Apparently, he fixed the sounds or added new sounds. He added a bunch of sounds. So I want to go through the sounds because this is my first time on a Mac being able to go through his sounds in its entirety. Subway. It's all good. People are angry. They don't know how to express their anger, so they hit the dislike button. It's the least of my worries. And keep watching it for 3 hours. What? Man, switch to Ableton. You like Ableton? Ableton, something visually about it that just makes me so bored of Ableton. It's just everything looks the same. Like you see how in FL, the channel rack looks different than the playlist? In Ableton, everything just looks like one big, like, piano roll. And so I don't know. Somebody needs to go in there and just copy FL Studio or something. Because that's the only thing I feel like Ableton's missing is just a channel rack type of thing. And then that's really it. Just so it's easier to write drums. The drum programming is not very simple. But that's just my critique. I mean, these are awesome companies nonetheless. You want Hermes? Watched your ad for 3 hours. Oh, you watched your ad for, that's funny. No, that's hilarious that you watched it for the entire thing and didn't even, but thank you for watching that. Cool. Yeah, I have some new ideas because I did kind of step away from the YouTube, like my typical content. You might not have noticed because I kind of interject some dope tricks here and there, but for the most part I changed my energy that I give to YouTube since March. So ever since March I wasn't giving you that YouTube kind of edited video, you know, what's the word I'm looking for, like entertainment style YouTube stuff. I've just been doing hardcore, like, here's how you do this type of thing. But now I think I have some new ideas and new energy and I'm going to get back to my more entertaining program. But yeah, I did take a little mental break from YouTube for a second. Even though I kept videos coming, there was a mental break. Just letting you know. Because I don't like to edit videos because it takes too much time. It's a waste of my time. And video editors are flaky. They either charge way too much or they're not consistent. It's just something about creatives. They are just not consistent. Like, it doesn't matter how good they are. They can't follow through with consistent delivery. And that's what screws like 90% of the creatives I've ever worked with, whether that's from video editing, whether that's content on the video side, or whether that's graphics, because I've dealt with software. And dealing with graphics is like the most, you know, they just do whatever. There's no consistent delivery. And I think, you know, maybe I'll do a more businessy video, but that's definitely something that is probably hindering your business. Many vocalists don't have the melodic range. Mariah Carey. Oh, you never noticed the ads? That's the, what's up, John? Yeah, so Facebook kind of tripped out on everybody who was using ClickFunnels, I heard. So now everybody's scrambling to figure out the Facebook ads. But I don't rely on ads, thank goodness. So I just got to keep focusing on serving you. All right, so I feel like the melody was so easy to make. Let's just go through different sounds. So this is the first guitar called First, what was it called? First Western? First Western. Okay. This is dope. The guitar backwards. He went in on these sounds. And this is no reverb. That little reverb. So once I have a decent melody, I'm just going to click the arrow to swap through the sounds. Jacob went in on these sounds. And you could add more effects to it if you want. Like the vibrato vinyl. It's called Octave Deluxe. I don't even know what... I was texting them, but I don't know what, like, how to get it. I don't think it's out yet. So, but my best friend Jacob makes it. If you want to follow him on Instagram, you can follow him on Instagram. His name is My Best Friend Jacob. But this is called Octave Deluxe. And again, I don't think it's out yet, so there's no website I can give you. He just sent this over to me. But his sound design is crazy. I can make like 10 different beats just from the sounds. Okay, let's make a beat and then let's see how many beats we can make. Shout out to Jacob. Here's one thing too, I realized at the studio. If you make a beat that's in a certain vein of sound, like let's say you like the drums or something like that, just save it as a new project and just change out the melody and the chords using the same exact sounds and see how many beats you can make. So I'll do that today. Thanks, Ricky. Can you show off Hermes? Hermes, maybe at the end of the stream, and I'll get into Hermes. Because Hermes is, you know, I'm going to have to give a whole dissertation about it. But it works for PC, Mac, and all these things. Okay, so let's get a song. What was I doing? I forgot what I was doing. Oh, let's grab some drums. Okay, at the end, I wanted to go like dun, 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 boom. So, boom. Let's see what happens if I like change that root note. Oops, wrong button. Maybe if I change it to, let's see. See how it like wraps up, even though I only changed four notes. It feels like it's wrapping the melody up and then it brings us back to the beginning. So that's the one mistake you guys make with the melody. You never wrap it up. You start one and then it just keeps feeling like it's not ending. Kanye. Yeah, it's crazy how Kanye's doing good, but then he's not even like focused on music. But I mean, if you want to, everybody makes money differently. Like Kevin Hart was a stand-up comedian until he got into movies. Movies was just paying him more. But he had to be a stand-up comedian in order to get to the movie level. So he didn't neglect being a stand-up. That was part of the process. Same with Kanye. If he never made music, would he really be Kanye? Could he sell a billion worth of shoes if he wasn't Kanye? And people forget that you have to have the substance before you hop into these higher levels of income or whatever. That's my theory. I mean, it makes sense. Somebody copies that. Yeah, I don't know why Ableton doesn't just pull a jack move like Instagram stole freaking Snapchat's stories. I don't understand why Ableton doesn't just like, I don't know. Maybe they're trying to be different. I don't know. Don't know. Not keen on the pink interface. No, the pink. You could swap the color out too. Multiple colors. Swap it out. Now swap it out. Now swap it out. Called the turnaround. Yeah. Long time since chimed in. What's up, Ascending Keys? Yeah, I was Oracle ended the live stream early, so I was like, you know what, let me just live stream. Nate too, I got Hermes. It is fire. I have it. About to get the two packs next week. I made a song with it. He played it last week. Dope. Scott Brown. I remember. Yeah, I'm going to have something where people can submit the songs they make with Hermes so they could be on the page where Hermes is. To hopefully increase the plays on their music as a thank you type of thing. But got to do things step by step. I have way too many projects going on, so I got to focus on one thing at a time. There's too much going on. All right, so let's grab some drums. I'm trying to think what drums I want on this. Okay, we needed something that goes like boom. All right, this is going to be like a Travis Scott beat, I guess. So let's see where... looking for bass. For whatever reason, I can't read today. Okay. I wonder if he means cubic zirconium, because that's funny. Fat CZ. I told you his sound selection is nuts. Let's go to pattern 3. Add this in. Oh man, I'm clicking all the wrong buttons. And we're just going to hold that note. Hit Control L to make the notes not overlap. Okay, so this is the new kind of style of bass. Hit Boy, somebody's asking for Hit Boy stuff. Hit Boy doesn't use your typical 808. He uses like this wow, like the bass has a resonance that falls down using a decay curvature. So it goes like wow, 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 like that type of bass. So switching up to more of like a Detroit West Coast sound. Like that, this is the exact sound I was just... Jacob's ear for sound is way different. Soft clipping. Now here I want to make it unique because it needs to match the melody. So it needs to be doom. Then it needs to be doom, boom, boom. Should match. I'm going off my ear. So see, there's two sections of melody. It's like the beginning part, and then it has to wrap up on the second part. So that's the number one thing with your melodies, is that you never wrap up the melody. It just plays the same thing over and over and over again, which is fine sometimes. It depends on how you do it though. Watching your videos, but I just can't get my drums to hit hard. Oh, okay. Oh, that's what Hood Gnome was talking about? Yeah, let's talk about drums. Yeah, RP, King Von. I don't know the whole situation of their beef and all this, but I do remember he made a song like, "If I Should Die, We Gonna Up the Murder Rate," something like that. So, I mean, there had to be some kind of beef going on, but who knows? I'm not in the street stuff. Don't know. I do know women tend to be a common denominator between beefs. Women need to stop starting wars. They're playing games. Let's go to My Best Friend Jacob. Let's go to samples. Let's go to drum kits. Let's find a kick. I found the playing stuff by hand, even if you don't have a MIDI keyboard controller, it's important. So 1, 2, 3, okay, so that should match. Now I use this kick because it's more high frequency based as opposed to just a boomy kick, because most of the time, most of the time with the kicks, people use too much boom in their kick and it clashes with the 808. So I'll show you how to make your drums hit. It's already hitting, but let's find a hard snare. So one thing I do, which is kind of weird, what's up, skinhead, is I'll use my arrow, my up and down arrow. I'll play the beat, hit space bar, and then I'll hit up and down, and then I'll turn my head so I'm not looking at the names, and I'm just listening to which snare sounds good. Oh, really? Yeah, I haven't been keeping up with politics. This one's fixed. I like that, like, that by accident, but it sounds cool. So let's add that at the end. 1, 2, 3, doop, doop. So wait. 1, 2, 3, doop, doop. 1, 2, 3, boop, boop. So my new favorite shortcut is Control L. It just auto routes sounds to the mixer. It just saves a lot of time. So the reason it sounds slow right now is we don't have any hi-hats. So I got to create a snare and then a bounce snare. So it's 1, 2, 2. See how it's too bare? We need something in between. Now it feels like the gaps are filled in. Will you write lyrics? Boom bap? I mean, if we make a boom bap beat. How much is octave? I don't even know. There's no page for it yet. It's not even online yet. So shout out to everybody in the chat. Here with you. It's funny because DoorDash tried to send me a notification to try and trigger my emotions of hunger. They think I'm at the studio wanting Subway, but I'm not. Rich home. For this, I don't need Soft Clipper. I think people overly use Soft Clipper because I taught them that one technique. But if the drums are already have the texture you want, there's no need to soft clip. So also, what happens is people overly pump their kick and it changes the way people perceive your sound. Octave Deluxe, yeah, it's an update. I don't know if it's free. It's probably not free because it's a lot of new sounds in here. But what was I about to say, though? I forgot what I was saying. Oh. Every kick doesn't need to be slamming through it. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So this kick is already processed, so you really don't need to do anything to it. But let's say you did do something to it. Fruity Soft Clipper. And you ran it through Threshold. Forgot to add a Soft Clipper on the master track. Just to make sure that we're not clipping, even though it doesn't matter. But anyway, so let's say you're pumping the kick. But the big mistake, I won't say the biggest, but a big mistake. That people will go to the pre-computed effects and turn up boost mode. Like the kick does not need to be that big in this mix. It doesn't need to eat up all the attention of the mix. That's cool if you want to make like Curtis King beats where it's like the kick is the loudest thing and the snare is the loudest thing. If you're talking about records, the kick is not always the super loudest thing. Like, I know it's a style of AJ, for example, who submits every Friday for our song feedbacks. His style is to have the 808 is the loudest thing. That's not, you don't need to do that for every single track. What's up, Mr. Matrix? Mr. Anderson, what's up? See how this kind of takes all the attention away from the other stuff? I just need something that's short and to the point. I don't need it to eat up the whole mix. Let's see if we can fit an 808 in here. I think we have room too. Here's where it gets tricky. I don't think, well, let me see. Okay, let's see. Before I even make my statement, Let's go to our bass and let's open up an EQ. Let's just see how low the frequencies go. So this bass has some sub-frequencies at 60. So you could boost this. Instead of adding an 808, you could just boost that. And that should give you the like low end that you need. But if it's not going to change the sound dramatically, you want to filter that out because you want to make room for the 808. So we're going to cut everything below about 100. So we're keeping the tone to it, but we're getting rid of the bottom portion so we can add the 808. Now the next problem is the kick tries to occupy that same spot. So let's go to the kick and see this kick has a lot of frequencies in it. So we need to actually high pass filter. You can, depending on which EQ you use, they all have different filtering stuff. So I'm just going to use this gentle filter to get rid of some of that low. So I'm going to exaggerate it so we can hear it and then pull it back. So it has some of that like dum dum part to it, but it doesn't have, it's not like dum dum. It doesn't eat up the whole space for the 808 because it will cause a lot of clashing if you leave it there. And there's a really advanced technique you can use, which is sidechain a frequency band to make them not clash. So that's what I'll probably do for this one if they do clash. To be different, huh? Change my handle, used to be different. Oh, I see. And the question is, do we need the 808 impact? Wait. See how it just adds that beefiness at the low end, but we don't need it to be so animated. It doesn't need to be like doom 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 doom. What's up, Alex Payne from Moscow? 1, 2, 3. I just play random notes because I couldn't really hear the bass. Being honest, now I don't have speakers, so I can't tell how low the bass is. So I'm just going off of my headphones. So I pull this up an octave control up so I can hear the notes. Pull that one. Good looks, Navi. Even though that note is not the same exact note, we can get away with it because it's just mesh. Okay, let's pull this back down an octave, control down. Now, if you wanted to still make room, let's say your kick clashed a little bit with the 808. Now let's, I know I'm kind of moving fast, but let's move that frequency back to open up more of the kick. And if we hear it clashing, then we have to do another technique, which I'll show you. This kick doesn't clash with the 808. But again, we don't need it to be super, super loud. So they could probably use like a boom. I know I'm just all over the place with this, but I'm trying to show you how to make your drum sound more bouncy and tight. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, So right here, it's sounds too slow. So modern genres will drag this out. And we need to make it like a brr. So let's drag that out. Let's cut it probably at the halfway mark. And hit control. Excuse me, I'm speaking Mac language. Control, left click, and then hit Alt A. And then change your time multiplier. Change your range to 1. Change your range to 1 and change your time multiplier. We only want 3 hits, so we can get. So it goes brr. And that's just going to tighten up the perception of, what's the word? Perception of, like, the hardness, I guess. Also, we can add a filter to this kick. It's a little, has a lot of high end. just so it can fit in this vibe a little bit. So all those little tricks, but see how our ear is kind of listening to the kick. That's why I said you don't always want your kick to be the loudest, because it becomes, then we listen to the kick for the groove, and the groove is not based on the kick. So let's add the hi-hats in here. And again, I'm going to play these by hand. Whenever I want to make a hi-hat roll, I'll just hold the note down. So that's my trigger to remember to make a hi-hat roll. Let me practice. 1, 2. I kind of like it as just like, let's try it without the hi-hat rolls. Because like 1, 2, 3, 4, then in another land. Da, 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 da. Another trick, use your wrench tool. Turn up time shift on your hi-hats, because some people's hi-hats are so tight to the grid that they sound like amateur. Especially if you're doing the Travis Scott. See how this is panned kind of left? You can go to the mixer and pull that to the center. Mono. ClickFunnels had an issue, so that's why I said I don't even know where the plugin is. I think it's not up yet. He's still making the website for it, I think is what he said. Okay, so it's not, I don't know if it's available anywhere, but it's not up right now. So I forget when he said he'll have it by. But he gave me an early copy. So I'm hyped. Experiment with this 808. I just want to see where I could take it, because I want a little density, a little more saturation in it. Oh, free, that was a lot of saturation. But saturation doesn't always mean impact, so you gotta keep that in mind. Now it just needs background reverb. So, I mean, the beat's pretty much done. Let's open up a reverb. Reverb. I need to have this preset, because doing this every single time is pretty tedious. So we're going to set it to fully affected, and then we're going to send stuff through the reverb. And the reverb is an instrument. So when you think of it that way, it's the thing that glues all the stuff together, outside of compression, I mean. So we're going to run all the high frequency melodies through it. That's definitely not a high melody. Whoops. Now the plugin has reverb on it, so if it's probably weird to run reverb through a reverb, so I'm going to go back and turn the reverb on here off, only so that the reverbs match. Some people like to run their snare through just to have a tail to it. Super subtle, but it's something that matters for this type of sound. Now at this point you just level. The vocal is gonna make the groove. Also the melody's a little loud. So this is where you would turn everything down, turn your headphones up, and then here's the trick. Turn your headphones up and it will force you to turn everything down, because stuff will just be loud. So I'll do that now, but I have to mute my mic. thing just by turning up my headphones. And this adds what's called dynamic back to the track. So I could probably make a better 808 because the 808's kind of like boom, boom. It doesn't move a lot. So it doesn't add to the bounce because the hi-hats usually add the bounce. So let's say if I redid the 808. See how it's bouncier now? So something has to be the bounce element. So I'm going to redo the 808. 2, 3, 4. Hopefully I'm making sense. So since I didn't do the hi-hat rolls and like a bouncy texture, the 808 was too not bouncy. So everything felt like one linear thing. Now I don't even know if we're in key with the 808. Concept. So we're going to bring in that bounce over time. And here we're just going to mix it to make it sound bigger. Now we're not going to spend a decade on mixing because this will just, it's, the idea is there. Mixing is just going to pull it out and make it more vibrant. But I don't want to waste time on mixing because it's not a creative thing, like super creative thing. Feel like it won't add to the sound as much. I'll show you a couple things I do, like add a double to the guitar just to widen it out. Then you can pull it down on the mix because when you stereoize stuff or make it like more left to right, it's perceived as louder. You can actually lower it down in volume. Make the 808 a little more bouncy by cutting off the doom because it goes doom doom. I just wanted to go like doom doom. I don't know, it's debatable on the 808, cutting off the tail. Okay, I mean, it sounds super quiet in the headphones, but at this point, you just make stuff louder. Taking some of the outside of that guitar off just so it sounds tighter. You can see already just by turning stuff down, it sounds more bouncy. Again, we could spend all day on this. Just showing y'all little stuff. I mean, you know, making beats doesn't have to be super hard. I just think people make it hard so that they can justify their channels. Kind of like the 808 just ringing out like that. Let's start a new track because this one's kind of already done. Now here's the trick though. You want to save it as, actually since we're in the same drum kit, we don't have to save it as because it's already in the same drum kit. Cool dude. Jacob's Octave. I don't know if you're watching live, but this plugin is actually pretty flames. Pretty darn flames. Let's start another one though. Hold up, let's start here. And let's see. And I don't know if Jacob, if you're still listening, that was like two of your guitars. I still have like 300 sounds to go through. What are we calling this? Live stream, Octave Deluxe. There we go. Oh, freak two. This should be like number two. Trap two. All right, let's see what else Octave has. So, one other video I tried to show you Octave, but it was the one before this. So Jacob, again, I don't know if you're still listening. They were asking where to find it, and I just remembered so it's not out just yet, I don't think, if I'm saying that right. So this will be out soon, but I got like an early copy because me and Jacob did a lot of work together on separate stuff before. So he just let me in on the secret called Octave Deluxe. All right, so let's try this sound. Oh, freaking, it's crazy. I don't have my MIDI controller, so I'm playing with my QWERTY. Wait. Dang. It's like every sound, you want to make an entire beat to it. I want to go through the sounds, but it's like every sound is good, so I don't want to not make a beat to it. Let's figure out these notes. What is this note? F and C. So this is a fourth. No, technically it's a fifth from F. So let's see what we could do with it. Let's make a happy beat. So what we're going to do, hit shift. Hit shift, pull it down. So your brain is really listening to the top notes of a chord progression. That's what you're really listening to. Oh, some strings. Octave Deluxe coming free. It's coming free. That's I told them that's crazy. If it's coming for free, I would have paid like $100 just for these new sounds, because I know how much work goes into making new sounds. The fact that people are getting this for free is ridiculous. So try some strings, he said. You talking about expansion strings? Okay. Oh, look at this interface. I see with the Jameson style interface. Oh, that's so nuts. No, that's nuts. Off the rip, that's nuts. It just like stands out to my ear. Like, I don't even know how to process this sound right now. Yo, it's one of those sounds that just, I don't know how to describe it. Do y'all know what I'm talking about? Remember when we were in Omnisphere the other day, those who were there, and I played this weird sample and it just stood out from everything else. It was like a Furby sample. About to have an eargasm over here. Like, legitimately. This hits my soul for some reason. Why does that hit my soul? I don't know why. Wait. Now I'm going to change the melody. Hold on. No, today I'm not going to the studio. Just because I'm just going to take a day off from the studio for a second. Wait. Let's see what he has to say. Sound designer says, popcorn is crazy. This one's crazy. Let me see what popcorn is after I... Wait. Does this have glide on it? I forget. Yeah, it does. Let's put it on mono. I wish my plugin had a better mono. We need to work on that. Let's go. Wait. Oh, this is dirty right here. This is dirty. This is unfair. All right, he said try popcorn strings. Let's see what that sounds like. That's why I said his ear is ridiculous. And the sounds he picks is just like when we made that beat. For those who don't know, let me just play the beat to let you know what the heck I'm talking about. There was a beat where, I forget where to put it. BusyWorks beats, music, songs. There was a sound, doesn't rank it by freaking a date. Hold up. What was the song called? Was it this? Yeah, this sound. So listen, it goes like, ooh, yeah. That's like a Furby sound. Not as loud as I thought it'd be.
I just keep killing everybody, man.
But it's just like one of those sounds that just stands out. I didn't make it as loud as I could. But anyway, let's pick Popcorn String. That's what I'm saying. Like, I would have paid $100 just to get the extra sounds. This is a lot of sounds. Strings, popcorn, solo. Okay. And the interfaces change based on which one. So this is octave strings, and he has octave guitars. There's a little loop going. What's up, 7B? 7Bill. Let's see how this fits in. Hold on. Oh, he did a little, I see, a little. Wait, this could be the background. Oh, not in key. I wish I knew what key I was in. Instead of doing, let's just hold that note just so I could play a chord with the popcorn. So this note needs to be in there. From Iraq, there you go. Shout out to you. You know, our people probably like your people. Don't listen to our government. They're just haters. Because, I mean, if we knew each other, we'd probably be cool. Octave light. I don't know. You got to ask Jacob. I don't know all his pricing, but sorry, I don't have the answers for you. Best thing I can say is hit him up on Instagram. Or go to somewhere. I don't know. Or just go somewhere. Okay, let's play a chord. Too long, so oh, this is different. All right, let me change up the hold up. I like that swing to it. Whoa. Let's go. I wonder if I can do like a half step pitch bend, but using FL. Hold on, let me see if this is even gonna work. Like not using the plugin, but using this. Sounds like it pitch bends. I'm just trying to think of a creative way to do that. Let's right click, create automation clip. And I know it's going to get a little convoluted, but we're going to drag that pattern. What is it? Pattern 2. And we're going to drag it out on Mac. If FL, like, it's a little sluggish sometimes if you do stuff. Sounds weird. Shout out to whoever just spent some money with me. Thanks. Okay. Go to song mode. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I wanted this to go. Okay. Just listen to my brain. So I needed the pitch bend right here, but I needed the pitch bend in between. So we need to go to beat mode. Right click, create like a little thing. And let's change. The only thing is, if you change the range now, it's not gonna translate. Hold up. So it's enough of a pitch bend. I don't want to bore you to death, but here it goes like, and then it comes back down. I could have used a slide note, right? A glide note, my dumb self. I did all that hard work for nothing. It's almost like a melody, the popcorn. Okay, so I'm gonna use that as a background. I forgot we even had the sound. Time delay. Let's see what we can do with the drums. Oh, it needs to wrap up, doesn't it? It needs to be like bump. Mike, chickity check. My bad. Okay. My bad. FL tends to do things with the update. Could also use the vinyl. Pitch wobble. Duh. Make it get bendy. Hey. Pro sound designer, Jacob himself. Whoa. That's a cool sound. Oh, FL messed up our sounds. It's all good. I remember. Hold up. Pattern 4. Where are we going here? Pattern 4. This was... I forgot what that sound was, but it doesn't matter. The other two, popcorn, because that was the main thing, and some strings. Pattern 2. Where are we at? Pattern 2. This was our strings. And where are we at? Strings. Was it angry? I remember the name. Angry. Yeah, with this new FL update, with Mac, it's different than PC. On Mac, they force you to update. On PC, you have the decision to update. But FL just does its own thing on Mac, regardless of if they figured out the whole back end or not. They force you to update. And popcorn. Here we go. Popcorn. Coolio. Coolio. Dude, I got to plug up my phone. My battery's gone. 29, wait, patch 29? That's what it's called? Yeah, it does, or mine does. Maybe I have the setting turned on. Mine automatically updates. I'm telling you, where's it at? There's probably a setting for it. See, automatically check for updates. Mine does that. Let me turn that off. See, I didn't even know that was on. But anyway, mine automatically does it. Because it told me I have like FL whatever, and I never downloaded anything. It just did it by itself. Okay, patch 29, he says. This man knows his patch. Oh, it's a numbered. I'm slow. Okay. Aaron Vibrato Group. I wonder who Aaron is. This is so dirty. Yo, these sounds are like... I don't know. Something about these sounds that are piercing through me. Freak. Okay. Let's go to pattern 5. Uh-oh. What just happened? Okay, that's how we're going to wrap it up. And then it's going to loop. The heck? Can you hear me? Check, check, check. Microphone. I can't hear myself. Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. Check, 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 check. You can hear me? I can't hear myself. which means it's probably this program. Look, update required. Oh my gosh. It needs to update the ACE, whatever. Cannot be updated because you're using it. Oh my goodness. This is ridiculous. I can't even open it. Oh my freaking goodness. Sorry, FL. Sorry. Check. Okay. Why does that sound super loud? Can you guys hear me? I sound like 8 times louder. Was that loud the whole time? Check. You can hear me? Cool. Okay. So I guess whatever. It's always something with the OBS. All right. So I think we are good to go. Okay, now sounds are way louder now. Loud and clear. All right, now I got to go back and pick our sounds again. Let me see. Since FL abruptly interrupted me. All right. Without further ado, you sound the same. Oh, maybe it was to me I sounded quieter. Okay, anyway, it's a long story. I had to update my Apollo Twin, so I don't know if that had anything to do with it. But back to business. All right, so let me make sure you can see me. Cool, I'm green. Good to go. A little interruption. We call that a pattern interrupt in marketing. A little something to throw you off. All right, so this one was strings sustain. Right? No, that wasn't it. It was angry sustain. Here we go. Okay, and this one was popcorn. I remember that popcorn solo. Solo dolo. All right, cool. Now I got everything figured out. That's my bad about the whole audio thing. I think he's just waiting on a website. So he's just waiting on the website to be done. I don't want to put his business out. I don't know. I don't even know when it's coming out. I just know he's waiting on the site. Back to where we left off. Okay, so he said he thinks string 29 would go good with this. I don't know if he meant as a melody or... That string hits different. Oh, I like the ending. I want to do like... Hear that string? Let's go. Now I'm gonna go dun 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 dun. This string sounds crazy if it was sustained. If I make it sustained, I should say. You could take off the release. Kanye strings right here. Crazy. Oh, let me fix the release. Oh. faulty verb on the popcorn string. Let me make sure the melody. Now I'm gonna go like dan, 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 dan. Why does my thing keep clicking? What the freak? UA? It's annoying. So many things have to, I updated one thing, but now the other thing has to talk to the one thing after updating, and if it doesn't match up, then they go haywire. This is craziness. Not on a Friday. Let's make sure everything's plugged up right. Okay, we have this pass through FL going to the outs. So what's the issue? What's the issue here? Shouldn't be any issue. It could be a buffer length thing. We are at a low buffer length. Let's up it a little bit. Now, if we still get those interruptions, it's probably because I'm live streaming while I'm doing this. No, no, I'm just going to buy a computer and never update anything. Kind of like the bell sound. I might lay this string as a background sound. Swap out the sound. I like that sound, but I'm going to use it in a different spot. I don't even know what the sound I was using before was. You want to go completely off the grid? I have to run to the bathroom too. Drank a lot of water. Bad idea before stream. Let's take out some of the frequency here. Instruments track. Now I made some plugins for FL. Let's just see if we combine all these things into one track and then add effects to it. Where are we at? Okay, so they're all on one track. So now I'm gonna add an effect, and then I gotta run to the restroom real quick. Let's add Wizard Fi. I want to see how weird we can get. DJ Wraith. I'm just going to add pitch watt drift. A thumb piano. There's too many things going on. What's up, Deej? But simply running stuff through that plugin adds a sound to it. I gotta run to the restroom though. So I'm gonna turn my mic off. I'll be right back in like 2 minutes so you can get entranced by this loop. Thank you. All right, cool. Bring. Since I'm kind of stuck with that idea because I was talking too much, that usually is what happens. When I talk too much, I lose my whole momentum. You want to do it backwards? How can we do this backwards? I'm trying to think of a quick way to render everything. We would have to group this, highlight all this, hit Control G, right click, consolidate. I think this... Okay, it worked. Reverse that thing. If I had less notes, like less melodic notes, it would be cooler. Because the less the better. Because right now it's like, swip, 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 swip. Like the more swips you get, the less cool it sounds. So if I take out some of those top line melody notes, that sounds crazy. The steady note kind of makes a vibe. This actually sounds kind of fire. Good looks. Produced by Xanthia. Let's go. All right, let's see how far we can take this. Let's not. Now I want to hear like creepy chanting. Like. We need a reverb. All right, let's send this to the reverb. I need a reverb that has a longer tail, and I'm trying to remember which reverbs I have. What has a long tail? Maybe the Lexicon 224. Oh, that's the wrong one. I meant to do 4. Is it 480? I don't even know. Let's try this one because I clicked this by accident. Where are we at? Let's do large hall. And full solo wet. It's a little hard to hear. Let's pull up to some highs. Can't really hear the reverb. All right, so since there's like woof, like a lot of ups and downs, I'm gonna run it through waves to tame the peaks so there's not so many peaks. Running through a compressor. So a lot of modern rap is very compressed. I think what you're having is audio dropouts from plug-in switching, you think? I don't know. You could probably know more computer. I forgot he has one shots in here too. Okay. Liven this up with some drums. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. We don't need to record a lot of hi-hats. Alt Q, quantize. All right, so I'm showing you all a lot of little tricks here. So we need to get rid of lows. Let's use a high pass, but then boost the fundamental and then cut just above. Just trying to make it tightened a little bit. Add the life to it. This one's definitely gonna have an 808. Busy Works Heat, probably gonna use this one. Yeah, let's use this one. So boom, dum, dum. Let me pull this up an octave so we can hear. Pull it up an octave. Wait, dum. It's a little sharp, so let's pull it down a little bit. Wait, Okay, now I got the notes. Yeah, I'm only playing it this high octave so I could hear it. Then I'll pull it back down. Wait, I gotta figure out a rhythm though, so. Two, three, yeah. I think that's enough bounce on the 808. Alt Q, control down. Live stream. We live in on these streams. I'm gonna call this a living stream of consciousness. Is that corny? This is a living stream of consciousness. Let me get these sounds just lined up. We need something bouncy. That was dope. All right, so I'm gonna get a little Kanye for a second. Oops, shave off that. Alright, so my brain's gonna talk alienese for a little bit till I map the drums out. 1, 2, 3, 4. I messed up the ending because the keyboard didn't hit it. But what we're gonna do is just chop it out. Slide that bad boy over here, hit shift. Grab the ending, hit Control G to just make it all one thing. Hit Alt Q. Quantize. So we still need like a. I think the hi hats are too slow. Because everything's like 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We need it to be ratchet. So let's copy all this. Hit Shift. Grab it over. So right now the 808's acting as a transient, but we don't want it to in this beat because it's the way the 808 shape. So we need something of sharper transient to be. We need a kick of a sharp transient. This one should work. Wrong thing. I'm gonna do that to the high hats. Where's our hi-hat? I'm gonna pitch it down. It's like a Big Sean beat. So, okay. I know I'm just all over the place. I'll show you how to mesh all this together in a second. 1, 2, 3, 4. I forgot how the 808 was lined up, so it's got to fix a couple kicks. So, okay, so see how these don't match up with the 808? The 808 goes da-dun, and then the kick goes boom-boom. So they're off. So you generally want to match up your 808s with your kick. And I'll show you how to make them not clash. So here's how you make them not clash. Now this is a more advanced technique. You have to go to your 808 and we're gonna pull up the, what is it? Wave C6 sidechain version. This is complicated, so pay attention. Okay, so we need to go to our kick, find our 808 channel, which is on channel 10. Our kick's on channel 13. So go to 13, find 10, and you're going to right-click sidechain to this track. Now, we're not done. You have to go to the plugin, go to the settings tab, go to processing, go to stereo aux in, right-click, and change that to your kick. I think you have to turn this on. I'm not sure yet, so we're going to figure that out. Then you have to go to your compressor and tell it what it needs to do when it listens to the kick. And you have to change it to the external key. So in this case, I want the low frequency band to dip every time the kick hits so that the kick can live in the low frequencies. And you can change the range. You can change the range of the low frequencies here. So let's change everything below about 90. I'm gonna allow the kick to dominate that. Now the thing is, that's the weird part. This thing, see it showing it moving without the kick triggering. That's the one weird part about this. I think I have to use this band. Always mix this up. Let's see, manually. What I might do to kind of, this shouldn't trigger, the 808 shouldn't trigger, it should trigger by the kick. So that means I think I have to turn this little button thing on. I think that's what happened. Yeah, there we go, okay. So now every time the kick hits, see how it doesn't move unless the kick hits? There we go. So this is how, so when Kenny Beats, or whoever told y'all not to sidechain, he's talking about just sidechaining the whole 808. He's not talking about, from my opinion, he's not talking about sidechaining a frequency band, which is different. So in this case, we are sidechaining the 808. But I think he was just talking about in general for like EDM type stuff, people. So that's how you make your kicks that are a little bit boomier live with their 808. Now the kick is still, you could fill out the kick a little bit more. So let's do that. Let's go to Fruity Soft Clipper, turn up the threshold, and then push the kick just a little bit more, just so our ear doesn't perceive the volume dip so much. Peak controller, only thing about peak controller is that it just, I mean, I'm trying to think of a reason why I should, I don't know. It's a lot of steps for people who don't know, but I guess that's still a lot of steps. But technically, yeah, you could use peak controller if you want it. Oh, here's what I was gonna say about peak controller. It gets a little weird sometimes with their envelopes. So that's why I don't like using it sometimes. Their envelopes are shaped differently because sometimes it'll like stutter. It'll be like, it'll go down, but then it'll stutter a little bit. But you could technically do it that way. Okay, let's push this kick a little bit. So that was a really advanced mixing technique, if you care. What's up? What app is it? We're gonna push this kick a little bit. Push it too much, it becomes scratchy. We don't want it to be scratchy. And I'm gonna tell it just to dip the volume a little bit more. So we're gonna change the range to about 10. And you want it to be zero tech because you want the volume to go down immediately when the kick hits. And the release is gonna be however long the kick is. So in this case, we're gonna do 30 milliseconds because the kick isn't very long. If you want to be scientific about it, you're technically trying to measure how long the frequency lasts for a certain time. So technically in a kick, the frequency isn't always boomy. But if you wanted to check, you would open in an audio editor. You would left click, highlight it, and to the right, it gives you the milliseconds. So this is 147 milliseconds of a sound. We're only telling the 808 to dip off for the first part of this, which is about 50 milliseconds. And the rest of it will overlap. So I know that's really advanced. One person will probably even understand what the heck I just said. Do you ever use NI solid bus compressor? No. So that's how you make like boomy kicks live with boomy 808s in peace. And I can kind of make it blend a little bit more with some saturation. So let's open up another track only for saturation. So I'm creating an aux for saturation. Let's move this reverb somewhere. Also, I meant to cut out the lows on the reverb. I can add a little mud. Everything's trying to live in the lows. Let's see if we pitch up the sample. Put it on stretch mode. Sounds weird. Need a little bit of gripping on the ear, so let's add some hi-hat rolls in here. One, two, da da da, one, two. So like, da da da, a quarter beat. I forgot what the melody even sounds like forward. It's a little active. Let me turn it off for a second. If I did use the forward, I would use less 808s to match the gaps. Grab the 808, send it, we're gonna send a duplicate. Just left click this arrow, it's gonna send a duplicate to this track. And this track will be only for saturation. You can use the capitator, you can use, what's the other ones? I have another one called the abuser. I don't use this a lot, let's try this one. I think this is a saturation plugin. And the one's called the Loch Ness. Turn up the drive. So it's duplicating the 808 and then running it through this saturator. Let me crank it all the way because it's hard for me to hear. Interesting sound. I feel like we have too much 808. We definitely have too much kick. So let's create two different sections. I need to plug my phone up. Give me a second. Let me add some piano to this. And I'm all over the place. Let me spare you the ear fatigue. I don't want the kick to keep bumping or else we'll... Let's see if we can add some keys. I have to play it by hand and that would take me forever. But the melody would go like. And I don't feel like playing all that, but that's how we go. Let me just see if I can find a weird sound to add over time. Thank you. like stuff like that. Got Storage vibes. Watch us completely transform this entire track. What's up, Apex? All right, so I need to move a little bit faster because I'm going talking too much. How long have we been going? Hour and a half? Yeah, I need to move faster. We only made 2 beats. All right. Promise I'm going to move faster. Control Z, man. Where'd it go? I'll delete my audio. It won't come back. There we go. Make a 50 cent beat. Let me mute this before it blows our ears off. Let's add delay 3. Sometimes that thing wilds out and it screams at us. I might change up the drums. Yeah, let's change up the drums for a second. So it's bum bum up, so boom boom, 1, 2, 3. Oh, I forgot to turn the kick down. Yeah, because we're not used to backwards music, so we need some kind of musical tangent to make it make sense. So that's why I'm adding other sounds to it. 1, 2. Forgot to kick super loud. Turn this kick back down. Let's see if this 808 works with a new kick. I don't know. Turn the 808 down. I don't want to blow our ears off. Oh, you know what? Let me make sure that. Yeah, okay. I'm still gonna add more instruments. Give me a second. Perfectly tempo sync, but that's fine. I want it to be a little bit off. So that gives me like a future Southside vibe. Did it record? Let us see. All right. We're definitely gonna compress this and turn it down. because it's too all over the place. What's up? Do what? The feedback you're talking about? We're doing it at 9 p.m. Oh, I just saw the comment. Sally said, no, 9 p.m. Eastern time. 9 p.m. Eastern time. So we have about an hour and 30 minutes till. So I'm trying to change this whole idea. We started one way. It switched up. Let's see where we can take this. One thing, though, is I'm talking too much. Let me just do what I got to do. I'm explaining every little step, which takes away from the... But I'm going to heavily compress. Probably going to redo the 808 rhythm. A couple 808s that are like swinging. Kind of makes it too gappy, and I'm all over the place, y'all. Too many gaps. Just clicking all the wrong buttons. Wait, da-da-da. Try to overly push the 808 just to see something. I just want to see how hard we can push it. Screaming 808 here. And turn it saturated. Do a couple tricks. Let's widen out the saturation with a doubler. Okay. So now the 808's perceived as wider or louder. Shows how important 808 shaping is. I don't want to get into every little detail here. There we go. Something happened with the kick here. Kick is playing super offbeat. One, two, three, 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 three. I'm in the 808 though, but there's a unique sound I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get like a wide, chorusy, but saturated 808. But we're doing too much mixing. So let me add one more. Just kind of messing around. I'm gonna loop record it just in case. Musicality. So important that we practice. You see that now the song, now the music stacking up. It still needs like a fast element to it. I still want to, okay, I'm talking too much. Let me just do what my brain says. Into like a verse, and let's just copy this chord thing, copy everything over, and then take out stuff. So let's see, we need to taken out the 808. No, the 808 kind of makes. Missing something, so maybe we can add something new here. We'll be right back. just gonna add that lead in there. Just this, it has like a mysterious sound to it. I thought it was going to be more impactful, but it's a background sound. All right. This reminds me of a, I just saw a video of DJ, Chop Squad DJ at 1500 or Nothing's Academy, and he was playing like a sound similar to that. Rance, I think his name is. All these little things tucked behind the beat. I think we use probably a couple hi-hat rolls in here. Something like that. Let's make this unique. Okay, let's drag this out. Hit, where are we at? Hit Alt-A. So let's, I know my brain is just talking like an alien, but this is how you do it. This is how you do it. Na 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 na. This is how you do it. So I'm liking these beats. It's not like any scrap beats, because usually when I'm in the studio, I have a couple scrappy beats. So I'm happy with this. Shout out to Octave Deluxe. It all started with this. Sounds like a Drake sample. Alright. Still a lot of leveling and stuff I have to do. Again, I wouldn't push the kick that heavy on this one. He needs vocals to liven it up. He needs like saturated vocals or something. Also, is there a reverb track? Yeah. Send instruments to reverb. Claps are dancey. Let me see. I do want a shorter clap. Because this one goes like, it kind of fades. I just want the clap to be like, but I don't want to obsess, because I can obsess easily. Oh, wait, we might be able to do it this way. I just realized the length. Yeah, like psh. Hold on a second. I don't know. I'm doing too much. If I do a snare, then when I definitely have to do percussion and all this. I feel like a snare, it's not the right vibe. Type of snare. This has to be pitched down though. It's an optional snare. I'm not gonna keep it in the whole beat. Boom, clap, 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 boom, clap, 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 boom, clap. So boom, boom, clap, clap, clap. So it needs to be dum. Boom. A little tail to it. But it's not gonna be the main event. I don't know. I feel like now I need another snare. It's too much. It needs like an offset snare. Like this or something. But this needs to be pitched down too. So, what did I just click? Body, body. All right, let's play from the beginning. Thank you. try one thing. Let me see if the isotope compressor has an input. Not sure. Because one thing I'm starting to learn here with compression is side chaining, creating dynamics. I don't know if they have an input though. Now, I think on, trying to think how I could do this. Give me a second to think. I think, what is it, neutron? One of these has a sidechain input. I think it's a neutron. And let me see. All these interfaces look all crazy and different. This should have an input. It says input 2. Let me see if I have neutron 2. I don't remember how to use half this stuff. Or I could just use the C6, but then that's not a whole band. That's only a multi-band. Give me a second to think. Or I could use the C1 sidechain input. I wouldn't usually use this on a master track though. Not saying that it matters too much, but I'm using it because it has an input function. And let's see if we could even figure out how to use the input function. Sidechain. I forget how to even turn the sidechain on. Let me think for a second. Okay. Oh, it's based on EQ mode. I don't think that's an actual sidechain. That's something else. What compressor has a sidechain input? Or I just could use a C6 and then just have a compressor control everything. That's what I'll do. I know this ain't making no sense, but it'll make sense in a little bit. We can't get a whole band going, man. All right, so we need to sidechain the kick to the master. Just gonna turn off the 808 for a second. That's right, I forgot. We can't use this on a master track. We're gonna have to bus it into a mix bus because sidechaining to the master just makes it silent, so that's not gonna work. Which means we have to route everything to a mix bus. Which means we're probably gonna have to route all this stuff all over again. FL just needs to remember the sends. This is tedious, okay. Again, I know I'm not making sense. So now we're grouping everything on this thing called a mix bus, which I should be putting all these plugins on the mix bus instead of the master track. So I'm going to copy this thing and place it over here. All right, we should be good, I think. Sorry, it's taking for me forever because I can't think of which plugin has a sidechain. So sidechain means that you can set it to where the kick will tell the compressor to act so that your track, the groove about your track is based around an instrument. It could be your 808, your kicks, it could be your vocals. Might do the 808 as a sidechain. But the thing is we're grouping directly to it. This is driving me insane. I guess what you would do is you just select the input. I don't know if we have to create a sidechain for this. Okay, so 808. So the 808 is gonna trigger this compressor. If all works as it's intended, the 808 should. It looks like it's working. So what it's doing is listening to the 808, and then that dictates the compression over the whole track. Now it only gives me this little small band because I can't figure out how to do this with a regular compressor. I just know in Pro Tools, it's easier.
I'm trying to think though, what plugin can let me compress? C1
sidechain. Just making sure there's no other better option. But anyway, this will only compress like the mids. So every time the 808 hits, the mids dip a little bit. So now the groove of the track is based on the 808 hitting. And it just makes it so that your ear can grab onto the track a little bit more.
A little secret trick for y'all.
So maybe you're talking about there's two things under your audio settings. If the lower your buffer length, it's called, that's one reason. Because when I talk, there's a small delay and then I hear myself. So your buffer length is the first place. But if you're talking about just hearing yourself in general, you need to click on your microphone track and click this little up arrow. Talking, but you can't hear me if I arrow. So now see how it turns me off. So there's two ways you can fix that, but chances are it's the buffer length for you, or you're using too many plugins and it creates that time delay. All right, just add a little bit of saturation to it. It could be a plugin causing the delay. Chances are, like if it's a CPU heavy plugin, that's why. So when you're mixing, you usually want to stay around -8 or lower for your input. Hold on. So that you can use plugins to make it louder. A little mud in here. I think it's the saturator. No, it's a stereo imager. Interesting. So the reason I'd put the EQ after the imager is because I'm widening everything out. What's considered on the side is now increasing. something unorthodox, which is a de-esser with a high pass at a certain frequency, let's say 8K. It's taking out a lot of dB, so we just want to pull it back. I think we spend a lot of time on this track. 2 hour mark, my body knows when it's 2 hours. Give me a second. I still feel like this track could be compressed harder with the instruments. So that's why I grouped the instruments. And it looks like they ungrouped. That's why I said there's so much going on. All right, I'm trying to think of a fast way to do this. Let's group the instruments. I thought they were grouped. Going to add compression to this group. as FL would do, it changed the input. It changed the input for the sidechain. That's why the groove got lost. So I'm doing too much right now. We're going too deep into mixing. Just want to move to the next idea before we have to go live at 9 p.m. So what happened was on the sidechain, the external input changed. So it went to the clap. I don't know how that happened. FL just does that randomly sometimes. That's why the groove was a little bit different. The limiter back, and then I'll move to the next thing. I knew the 808 was stripping. It's because the kick, that's why. The kick got turned off from the 808. So all these little things change, and FL doesn't tell you. So that's why the 808 was sounding like that. I was trying to figure out why it was so like, never mind. My routing got changed. Completely forgot about this. Play it one more time and then we'll wrap it up and move to the next one. Add up, like side chaining matters. If you don't route it back, if you don't side chain the frequencies, all those little tiny things matter. It still has a little bit of like masking going on, so I have to come back to that when my ears can differentiate. Let's make another track, and then I got to get ready for the live stream. So let's do it. Cool. Let's call this live stream octave deluxe. I got wait, oops, it's called Octave Deluxe Melodic Trap 3, even though it's our first version of it. Okay, let's open up Octave. Octave just has a ton of sounds in it. Where are we at? Octave. This is Octave Deluxe, it's not out yet. And let's see what we got. Made by my best friend Jacob. It makes a lot of dope sounds. That was accident, but that sounded fire. Can I get those chords back? Let's see. Oh yeah, there we go. Let's see what chords we just played. What was that? D, what is this? D, G, and F. I don't even know what kind of chord this is. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I don't know. It's a different type of chord. That sounded super. It must be a stacked tone because there's no way this is just three notes. Maybe it is. This sounds like it. Okay. I'm talking too much, so I want to go dun, dun, dun. So. I'm going to copy this whole chord, pull it down. Wait, dun, dun, dun. This mic and the noise, y'all hear that? That must be annoying. That's the MacBook noise, by the way. The sound gives me like a Living Singles vibe, like that TV show. Living Single, ooh, in the 90s, time the world. How much is Octave? I have no idea. I think this update's free for people who own Octave, but I would easily spend $100 on these new sounds. So he should definitely make it pay. I don't know what he's doing with it, but according to him, it's free for people who own Octave, these new sounds. How much Octave is, I don't remember. Trying to make like a fast R&B. Here's the little thing. So if the mood's sad, you can go to tools, flip it vertical. It flips the mood, so now it should be happy. Sounds motivational. Almost there. Let's control Z that. I need some 90s chords though. It's hard to play chords on a QWERTY keyboard. I like these sounds though. All these sounds are crazy. Here's my trick. When I feel like I can't play, I'll just hit shift up or down to change the key. Let me pull in a real progression because my little accidental progression. Let's drag in MIDI friend and let's go to an actual R&B progression. Let's go to, where is it? I always mix these up. Now we have a vibe. Jacob's sounds are just insane. Sounds are so crazy. Like, I'm into sound design, so I understand how, like, these sounds are, when it's analog, it's like, it feels different. It feels like I could see an image in the mono. So I need to make a track before we have to go live, so let me just get to it. I can sit here all day going through sounds. We didn't even go through half of the sounds. I want a doom type of beat. Let's go to Oracle Sounds. Cassette drums too. I need like a percussion. I'll be quick because we don't have time. So cut group needs to be the same. So cut group 3, go to your wrench tool, make sure it's cut group 3. And I think we need swing. I'm not sure how swing is going to work at a higher BPM. So if not, we'll use the time shift under the graph editor. But it needs to be boom, da-boom, 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 da-boom. But I think it needs a little bit of swing from what I remember. Wait, see the timing's off. Not used to this genre. See how it's just like boom, clap, boom, clap, boom, clap, boom, clap. There's no real swing to it. So the key is to add swing. And also the sound's a little long, so I'm shortening the length here. And it's a little bright. We'll get to it in a second. So anyway, go to your graph editor. Go to the shift tab and then pull this up. Or let me see what swing does. Swing might apply. Hold up. No, it doesn't apply there. I'm trying to think how swing would work note by note because it's a little bit different. a second to think. I think that this is just too long right now. I need to shorten it. It's too long. Also, this kick's pretty big. Could use a little bit of tightening. Like, the kick could be a little left. Let me see if I do it this way. How will this sound? Yeah, there we go. This is weird because you have to put the notes offset, which doesn't make any sense. I'm trying to think of a better way to do this. That first kick is just too late. It needs to be like a hair earlier. It's too loud too. I guess what I could do is move the music to the right. That 3/4 grid gets confusing to me. It's because we're in a high BPM. Let's just put it down to 90. I don't know why I'm trying to be fancy. That's why. It's because we're in a super high tempo. I'm trying to manually do stuff that the swing parameter would do, which is making this way more complicated than it needs to be. So let's just make it easy on ourselves. Pull this in. So these aren't the exact drums. I need something less punchy. But whatever. So we're gonna do kick, turn this swing up. I don't know if this is the kick's too long or what. Might have to play it by hand. This is getting annoying. I think the kick's too long. Delay these chords too. Could be better. It's not the greatest swing, but whatever. I'm doing way too much. I'm trying to do a genre that I'm not used to, which is one. Making all these compensations for it. This is making modern R&B. And then with those chords, we're doing too much. Spins 808, you already know. Thank you. Let's try something weird with the chords. I'm gonna use an arpeggio.
Thank you.
just need one more like developing sound for the melody. I might use my keyboard. Take a break and then we're gonna come back live. So this one, knee vocals, it's bare. I want an aux effects for the arp.